Thank you, Congresswoman Kamik. Madam Speaker, in light of the U.S. Supreme Court oral arguments for the landmark Dobbs versus Jackson case earlier today, I would like to highlight what is truly at stake here. That is millions of precious innocent lives. It all comes down to one simple fact. The presence of a heartbeat means the existence of life. As early as 5 weeks, unborn babies in the womb can have a heartbeat. Furthermore, they start developing pain receptors just 2 short weeks later and are able to process pain by 15 weeks. Anyone who claims an unborn child is not a human life is ignoring science, denying morality, and condoning murder. That's right, murder. Even President Biden acknowledged back in 2015 that, and I quote, "The moment of conception is a human life and being," end quote. On this rare occasion, I sincerely agree with the president. As an unapologetic pro-life American, I will never stop fighting for the sanctity of human life or defending the unborn. While we wait for further developments in this pivotal legal case, I am hopeful the eventual outcome will save countless innocent human lives and not add to the already 60 plus million who have lost their lives to abortion. To put that number of 60 plus million into some perspective, the number of Americans killed in combat in the entire history of our nation, starting from the War of Independence, is just under 667,000, or about 1%, 1% of the 60 plus million unborn babies who have died during the last 5 decades. I pray that this crucial moment will confirm for all Americans that every life is precious, worth saving, and made in the perfect image of God. And that revelation is a victory we should all celebrate. Thank you.